pretzel?
She wants a million pretzels, but instead she's just watching you eat.
It's a mental appetite suppressant. You know what else works? Imagining someone throw up. Or if I'm really hungry, picturing someone I love getting into a car accident.
I use that same stuff during sex. You know, to put the brakes on.
That was the front desk. Rhonda's on her way down. Pucker up, people.
Like, pucker up? What's going on?
It's evaluation day. Every 6 months, Rhonda and Neil sit down and decide what our bonuses should be.
What do they base it on?
How good you are at your job.
What? Why didn't any of you dongs tell me this? I've been bringing my C game since I got here.
Hey, Rhonda. Wow, what you reading there?
You look hot.
Wow, looking good. Love the earrings.
Super skinny.
Yeah.
A wonderful way to start my day if I didn't know you were all just working me. Well, what about you? What you got for me?
I'd like to think that any bonus I receive will be based on the passion and skill I bring to my job.
And?
I totally do you.
Guess that was offensive.
Don't speak for me. You don't know what I like.
Rhonda, I really need this bonus. My roommate moved out and stuck me with all the rent.
What happened?
Why is the beautiful wife of the owner carrying her own bags? That's my job, which I love.
Thank you, Gus.
Hey, no, thank you. It is a privilege to be here. Okay, getting paid is just a... God, what's the word? Bonus.
Neil, I love what you've done with the place. You have really made it your own.
Well, it's not his own. It's mine. Yeah.
Haven't you taken an awfully long break?
Oh, I'm sorry. Are you handing out bonuses, headset? Sorry, Molly. No time for chit-chat. Gotta go be awesome at my job. Looking good, boss lady.
It's a crock, but I want to put him in my pocket.
Neil's in his office. He's still pissed, and he's not gonna talk to Rhonda.
Well, she's not going to go to him, so... Great, we're never going to get our bonuses.
All we have to do is get them to make up so they have the meeting.
Yeah, because I didn't put in almost a half day's work for nothing.
I got this. As a child of an alcoholic home, when my parents fought, I used to create a new crisis so they'd have to come together to fix it. You can't believe how many times they thought I was pregnant.
Can't we?
My parents used to argue all the time, too, like about bills and groceries and whatever. This one time, my mom was having trouble with her 19-year-old boss and kind of stabbed him. And my dad was like, Caroline, not again. So, yeah. Anyway, what I used to do to smooth things out was give one parent a gift and say it was from the other one. Except this one time I gave my mom a letter opener, which I'll never forget because I had to testify about it.
It occurs to me that we could go another way. I was a psychology major, Hofstra, and we learned that the best way to confront someone is to mirror how they confront others. So all I gotta do is give Rhonda a taste of Rhonda.
Hey, get the hell on out there with whatever business you got. You feel me?
I do feel you, Rhonda. Just gonna think about it.
Okay, where's my check and where's the line of people waiting to thank me?
Thank you for what?
I'm the one that got Neil and Rhonda to make up.
No, they made up because Neil was dosed.
Right, create a crisis, bring them back together.
You're the one who did it?
Yeah, that one always worked with my dad. One time, I spiked his martini with nail polish remover. A couple weeks of my mom feeding him through a straw, he dumped his secretary, moved back home.
Wait, so Austin got fired for nothing?
Oh, no. Neil's scotches were like half pee.